about that.
I am loving that military jacket. That is hot.
That's why I took it off.
I'm sorry they're not green this time. I'm so sorry. There's white there, though. That's for you.
All right, you got questions and answers, guys. I have the answers.
Absolutely. We'll get started right over here with these people in mind. How nice. Go ahead, sir.
Hi, Jason. I realize this is supposed to be Green Week weekend, but as a father, it's kind of interesting seeing my kids knowing who's the Black Dino Thunder Ranger. But always when I come back, you know, almost kind of like as, you know, the Zordon role, and, you know, and reworking again.
I would call it Zordon
role. No, I think it felt good to be back. I mean, for a whole generation, you know, Dino Thunder seems like yesterday it was good, you know, and, but it feels good just switching different generations and having the kids that have kids. Now you guys have grown older now, you have kids, so, you know, couldn't handle the fourth generation, but so far three generations, it's going strong. Thank you.
My question is, you played a villain one time back in the original series. Would you ever consider doing the villain again for the main series as the main villain?
I think being evil is always fun. When I first got the role, I loved acting. I just wanted to stay committed to it and stay dedicated and all that stuff. And, you know, who knew it was going to be this big, but I believed in it. I just really did my job, and that's what I've been doing for years. And, you know, I mean, no matter where it goes, from one fan or a thousand fans or a million fans, I guess I'll still be the same where I am now, doing what I'm doing. It was my own person. Yeah. You know, so I'm happy to be here.
I think it's part of it is you, though. You drove that fame. Because I remember watching you when the show first came on, and you were different than the other actors. I mean, I noticed you. I didn't know that I was going to work with you years later, but you were different, and really you could see the passion, and that's why you have the school to teach.
Yeah, I teach, and I'm very passionate about it. I like the character role, too. It was kind of like I was on, you know, kind of stuff, so it was definitely fun.
Well, you were the leader of the group, really, and it helped the kids watching to say, hey, I can become a leader, too. I don't have to follow the crowd. I can do my own thing. Oh my God, no! Stan Lee! Did you know that was coming, by the way?
What? No,
did you know?
didn't really know him. I mean, I heard maybe. I just wanted to get to my Q&A to see if that, you know, something special guest was really coming.
Oh my god.
But pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, superhero beatdown. I was going to ask him when we talked to, but definitely went to Matt, which was probably a great range, but I don't want to ask him. I'm a huge, I used to collect comic
books. X-Men, right? You like, we'll read it. Like,
Danny and Jenny, you just missed Stanley.
Oh my gosh. Oh, there's my little friend. Oh my gosh. I love your daughter.
Yeah, that was definitely cool.
That was
all
amazing.
Well, collect ourselves.
I feel like that too, that we got to go convene about this. That was incredible. What an incredible moment. I loved it.
I love about Stan is that for his 91, right?
Yeah, we celebrated his 91st.
91st birthday. So much energy. He just loves his fans. Like, if I would look at who I would want to model, you know, someone that recently, I would look at Stan, I think, man, how could he still be that? Like, after so many years, and he really does wear his fans. I haven't heard one. I'm out in the circuit pot, so I hear everything. I haven't heard one bad thing about this band. Obviously, take time to walk over here and interrupt the panel. I'd be afraid to interrupt his panel. I'll be stepping on security, be hitting me. Who get off? Stan, you said if I ever need anything.
They got it. I think they're all
good. When I first met Stanley, he walked in my booth, and I was a big fan of his. And he walked with everybody. It was about like 15 or 20 people, just like you all, you know. So I played it off cool. Like, oh yeah, thanks for coming. I was really like, oh man. And after you left, but I told everybody, you all got that right on video, and they're like, what? You guys on video? And they just took camera pictures, and most of them were blurry. And I was like, no one was rolling video.
Amazing. Shall we go to the mic?
I
don't know.
So you're very active on social media and you're active with fans a lot. Would you say that a lot of that is what's caused Power Rangers to remain popular over the years, or even the surge in its popularity lately? Because not a lot of people do what you do as far as interacting on social media. That's really cool.
I try to keep that active. I think my opinion in here is I think that, you know, the Power Rangers, they were bought back by Spawn, who has the magical formula of how to make this kids market. Disney owned it, went down, they hired me for Dino Hunter, try to save the show, that's what literally just said, let's bring you back and try to save the ratings so we can all have a job. That was said, and that's what I did. Ratings came up a little bit and dropped again. Once Spawn bought the franchise back, then this Green Ranger, me, I see Green Ranger, but the Green Ranger become like this world icon, and like Hot Topics, and out of all the Rangers, I just, you know, there's certainly the cooler other Rangers out there. I mean, I'm just, I know y'all say no, but when you compare a helmet and a shield, with a shield, now let's compare character to character, that's what I think makes the difference between a driving Ranger, like me being socially active and all that. Booking tours, there's no other Rangers got Stanley coming in as a Ranger. You know what I mean? I mean, like, I'm on tour with these guys are huge fans. They're, to me, I grew up with all of them, like, you know. Y'all probably know, I'm a hanger arranger. All these guys I grew up with that I was just, you know, seeing, and I think, wow, Lou Ferrigno and all these guys, I'm like in a room, and I'm not saying anything, I'm eating at a table, and all this. It's just different for me, but embracing the character and talking to fans, really strong, that you can't just be, I think you're going to come to me for years and years. You have to be active in order for you to keep visiting, you have to give back. And I see a lot of celebrities that don't give back, and the numbers just, fans just start, and then they're wondering after 20 or 30 years, I wonder what happened. They need to go revisit what they did in the last 20 or 30 years and see what happened and how you can have a Green Ranger fan or a JDF fan or whatever else. You know, you learn the guy behind the mask, I guess. And I never want to be a disappointment to people. And when you meet someone like I have met, plenty of people have been very disappointed. And I don't want that to ever happen to you guys.
It will never happen because you're amazing.
Oh, thank you.
Hi, Tom.
say hi to his biggest fan.
Awesome. Well, thank you, buddy. I appreciate it.
And then we'll have a Morpher. And we have the Morpher.
I know the green, white range of Morphers are hard to get.
So now that you've appeared at least once in nearly every Aaron Copley group from Mighty Morphin and into Law Force, Former Brethren, and then Dino Thunder, now recently to Super Mega Voice, like, what do you think over the years? Can you talk about like all the stuff that's changed about Power Rangers over the years and then some of the stuff that stayed the same?
Yeah, I don't think thanks, buddy. I don't think the style of it has changed much. I mean, the monsters, and I think I like that because the monsters are the monsters still. And they don't look like they're not all CGI. They still look as cheesy as they were. They came out, and I don't mean that in a bad way. I mean, in a good way, kids love cheese. Like, I always talk about that. Cheese sticks, cheese sandwich, macaroni and cheese. So that hasn't changed. I think the chemistry has changed as far as what the split was on by Disney. And now that they got Saban has it back, it's still that they're trying to find that formula that worked before. And that formula was like a soap opera-ish for kids, but they developed each character so you guys can relate to them. You know, we had Billy who calculated every day. You know, we had Tommy who was the loner guy, and we had each individual one. So I think they're trying to reduplicate the formula, which, you know, is still a good tasting shake, but it's maybe not as best as the original, but it's still doable and it's better than what it was. You know what I mean? All I see, the difference from the show is just different actors. Like I tell Jenna, she wants to watch Power Ranger back in the day, and she's like, it's Power Ranger. I'm like, no, baby, that's not Power Ranger. She's like, what? I'm like, no, it wasn't my season, so I told her it wasn't. Like, you can't watch that. Old school Power Rangers. And it's funny how, like, parents, you know, get their kids into it and all that stuff. And I do have parents come up with kids, and they're like, hey, what's going on, man? He's a big fan. And the kid's like, no, Dad, you're okay. So I show up. Well, I'm here really for him. What's your name, Richard?
My name's not Richard.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome to see that. And I guess you can share that with your kids, you know? And I guess, I don't think people understand that when they can look at something and wonder, like, how a TV show or, you know, it's changed my life or music's changed my life, and people are like, how could that change your life? It is, because it's ingrained in your memory. When you see something like Power Rangers, it will take you back to where you were as a child. What you were going through as a child, good or bad or whatever it is, just like a song would instantly zap you back to 20 years ago, where you were, you know, when you were hearing that song. So I think TV and music definitely changes people's lives and to, you know, I don't know, to get older and actually do what you want to do, and go where you want to go, and you know, buy the toys you want to buy.
What did I tell you? Inspiring, right? Come on, this guy is unbelievable.
Are you going to do another Batman Sun video as a white ranger, or will you do
one as a reread as well.
Well, we'll talk about that. Aaron's got some ideas. You know, you guys know, and I introduced you to Aaron Battison, right? He's the creator and director and all. You know, yeah, you stand right there. There you go. We're working together in a few weeks on the project we're doing together. And then you can ask him a question. I'd like to see the other. I did want to ask him about the pre-read Spider-Man. I wanted to. I was just like,
I think at that point he would have said Green Ranger, which would have killed my whole argument. They'd be like, well, Stan Lee said it.
And, yeah, I know.
I think so too. That
night. But of course the Green Ranger would be like, well, there's no debate now, I guess.
Thank you.
Yo, you're welcome.
You had a very distinct evil laugh in the original series. Is that something you came up with on your own? They said evil laughs, and you're like,
where's Jenna? Jenna can't do it. Jenna, what about the evil laugh? I taught you how to do it. I just came up with that.
Did you practice that in the mirror?
Nah, I don't know. I thought it was like one of those like funny dumb things, like whoa, the world. I was like, I'll just do that, I guess.
Probably one of the easy old fame thing from last year. You gave a specific mission, a specific fan, and the question was answered. The challenge was given. Last week we learned CM Punk is no longer part of the WWE. So here's my thing.
You didn't video
him. I'm the one that had the original.
You are the one that did.
Yes.
Oh, I just posted that. It was funny.
Yes.
I like watching.
So are you actually going to reach out to him in a professional way?
It is. It's everywhere right now. Guys, I just blew up one. I put your video out there that you did last time. It's funny because I don't know if you ever seen this video. He's like, you know, CM did. You didn't think you could take Jason? Like, yeah, he goes, no due respect, man. Whatever you say, like, I don't think you could take him and all. He's like, it's good. Yeah. I like fans like you. Starting it up. Because you even started a whole bunch of stuff. So we'll see. It's on the MMA websites and all that. I'd like to. But I like CM Punk's theory on it. Because he's not like going out like, I'm going to beat people up. He's like, yeah, I'm just going to get beat up. Who doesn't want to see me get beat up? And I like it instead of him going, you know. So he's a cool dude. It just needs to happen more on the business side. Because I see him everywhere. You know, thanks for doing what you do.
Hi, there are some private filmmakers on Kickstarter that are doing the new MMPR series. I'm not sure you've heard of it, but the premise before they got their funding was that 20 years after the original series, Lord Zedd comes back and Tommy is the only Ranger left and he's going to get his revenge. Have you been approached about starring, or, and if you have been, do you think you will?
Well, you know, the thing is with that is it's touchy because it's not Saban approved. It's just a remake of it. It's very, very touchy when you do that stuff because there's a lot of things that I've heard about that, though. That's why I wanted to run into Aaron with Battinson. You know, filmmakers can be filmmakers, but you need the right formula to make this happen. And I just think that there's a lot of, you know, that when they started, it was just, I just didn't want to touch it because it's not approved by Saban. And I didn't want to go into it and then have Saban be mad at me and then not have Megaforce happen and then actually ruin the chance of me having some kind of Saban-approved series that I want to work on. So, obviously I wasn't included into it.
Well, if it goes successfully and there's another season and it is Saban-approved, could we see you in it?
I want to work with Saban, but there's no way that Saban's just going to hand over this guy $1 billion and say, thanks for stealing my license, here you go, here's $1 billion. That ain't never going to happen. The only thing that's going to happen is if you owe me $1 billion now. That's about it. So for him, it's not a win-win. As a filmmaker, it's a win-win, but when you start recasting Power Rangers, it starts getting weird. You know what I mean? It's like, you want to see a remake, but then you hire, like, I heard some guys, like, I'm playing you in the movie. I'm like, oh, cool.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Now we're going to do My Morphin Life?
Yeah, we'll just show the trailer of My Morphin Life.
Yep.
Just a minute and a half trailer. First episode's going to be airing in February. We got 10 cool, awesome episodes.
We just did a Jason chant for you before you came in the room.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's pretty good.
That's like the little people jump in on the
I can hear you again.
confirm yet. I do want to talk to Team Z and let them know that you guys, you know, are great. I'm excited about it. It's really for the fans and it's for the excitement of the show. I'm just happy to be here. My little girl is just in heaven right now. She saw me do the Green Ranger suit and saw all the helmets. Everybody's super nice. So we got approved to shoot anything and everything. We said we can shoot film crews wherever we want. We can tweet anything, Instagram anything, but it's all going to be positive. That's all I can do is positive stuff. So, Friday, we're free to do anything. Filming the dinner, anything and everything. Interview people, we're done. This is what fans want right here. I'm excited we got cameras, dude. Cameras. Booyah, baby, Hollywood, here we come.
It's movie time.
I'm just getting a little older, I forgot, but it all works, all right? My dragon dagger, fortunately, still works.
Oh my God, that was so good.
Yeah.
Let her go.
your food right there.
Aaron, if you have not checked out all the episodes, Bat in the Sun, you need to go check them out. Like Superman versus Thor, Wolverine versus, you know, we looked at this, even my wife was watching it, and she normally doesn't watch like a lot of stuff like that. But because some she loved this fight scene, and Aaron, that, I mean, if it wasn't for Aaron, that fight scene couldn't go any better. This guy, and I'm just saying, it's amazing. I'm really looking forward to what we were filming together, what it's going to look like, and all that stuff. And, I mean, if you give this guy the right budgets and high-quality camera stuff, man, it's going to go insane. Hollywood's going to be on fire. So hopefully we'll do some good stuff there. But yeah, if you guys have any questions about that, some of you all were asking last time, like the alternate endings and stuff like that, you can ask them about
that. Aaron, those seats were amazing.
Oh, thanks. Well, I've watched the Power Rangers for 20 years.
So you were a fan yourself?
I grew up in the pop culture area, so I was a big fan. I don't know if you knew, I was a big fan.
That's good.
This guy, 20 years of watching this guy. And I'm going to tell you, from every episode, you guys can go back in time and look at Power Rangers, first 14 episodes, before the Green Ranger was fighting in the alley. I was throwing the trash can lid. That's the first time we took that filmmaking style and applied it to the way Power Rangers based it. So, like, you know, just the certain cuts and the low angles, and we used to just shoot it all in the master. So, watch them. They're just, you know, a master shot, two shot, single shots, and then edit the fights. The fight scenes weren't that elaborated. But you mean, look at this stuff, man. So he's got a good team of people behind him, and there's an alternate. You see the alternate ending. White Ranger's skull gets crushed out. Everything goes through my head. But I'm going to tell you a funny story, though. We got this, and me and Jenna was watching even Tammy. She's like, you know, we have to search out our superhero powers. And I don't really know. You saw me on the video, I know now, but I didn't know what I was searching for. So I was thinking, well, you know, I'd show Jenna, and she's like, I don't know Scorpion. And so what kind of powers do you have? I'm like, I don't know. I wonder if I can call it. I'm searching on YouTube, I'm looking at Saba, I'm looking at all the stuff, and then we look up Scorpion, and it's the movie, and you know, all this, and so Jenna's watching, and she's like, yeah, I think you're going to die, Dad. I think that thing's going to chop your head off. It's awesome.
That's better than the alternate ending that we have. We filmed a much, much more gruesome alternate ending for the White Ranger's demise, which I forgot it back. There's no way we can go online.
Can you tell us about it? Can we hear about it?
It just was more Mortal Kombat light. It involved, at some point, seeing the White Ranger's spine all...
Oh,
yeah. It was cool. It's a big graphic. So, I'll show you. But to answer the Green Ranger appearing possibly on B-Town, would you fans like that to see Green Ranger?
Yeah.
But I'll probably show it because it's what we want to film something that I guess not just what the fans want, something that I'm also proud of that we put together that's going to be cool. You know, and I think that was my biggest thing on Power Rangers. I had no creative control at all whatsoever, which is fine, which is, you know, it was what it was, but I would have liked to see things darker now. That's because it's aging. We couldn't keep it darker than all.
We're trying to do now, but you guys email and Spawn hears you guys, so if you guys can vocalize, I mean, that's what makes it happen, so.
Well, Twitter, too, you know, JDF, are you JDF?
JDF,
because there's a couple.
Yeah, JDF, MMA was a long time ago, JDF, FFN on Twitter, JDF, FFN on Instagram, and then Jason and Brian.
Yeah, always include JDF, FFN in your tweets about the Green Ranger.
Well, I mean, when they were asking if I was going to return to Megaforce, like I just told someone, I said, I'm going to contact Saban and the legal department call. Like 2 days later, I said, you can't, our phones ring off, please, please, to go back to these other fans, don't call us no more. You can't do business. It was just after they had a certain hour that just kept lighting up. They're like, Saban and Jason Day, right? Saban and Tim, what is Jason Day? Saban, and so it just kept going and going. And it was like petitions online and all that stuff. And
what happened?
Yeah,
the power of the fans is huge. You know, JDF, we only have a few minutes. Of course, you know you're like my favorite guest of all time, and they know that because I talk about how amazing you are, and you really are truly, truly amazing. So inspiring. Now tell us, where are you going to be for the rest of the weekend? Where can the fans find you? Are you doing any, like, shows for them?
So today, Saturday, I have, tonight, the costume contest is going to be tonight. So
yes.
If you guys want to be a part of the costume contest, they're going to be filming the Sci-Fi Heroes of Cosplay. So they're going to be filming that for the Sci-Fi Channel. So if you all want to get in the crowd, you know, crowd shots. Got that coming up tonight. I'll be back at my booth for a little bit. I think the photo op today, the Green Ranger photo op, is going to be quick. We'll be, I think, at 5:30-ish, something like that, 5:30. So check the con guide. And then I'll be at my tables most of the day today, and then at the costume contest tonight. And then tomorrow, I believe at 2 o'clock, I should study this a little bit better. I believe there's a karate class that's not just for kids, but it's also for adults. So if you want to come and, you know, check it out and stuff like that, you should participate. I mean, at least, because I have like 100 people that show up and, like, you know, just video, and it's like, there's nothing to video. You all need to come and try it out. I'm not going to kill anyone or anything like that. I mean, not in the beginning, you know, that's
later.
That's what I got going on today. Aaron's got a Q&A, the Bat and Sun at 4:30, right, at 4 o'clock in the panel. So
will we see more of the film?
We're going to show part of our next battle. We'll answer more questions, all kinds of questions you guys have. Feet down and future projects. And
your next project you have is Master Chief versus Captain America.
Yep.
Oh, oh my God.
Who do you guys think?
I do all the motion capture from Spider-Man, so we've been going back and forth between Spider-Man and Green Ranger. This is probably not the best crowd. We're going to have Stan earlier.
Like, ultimately, not because I'm sitting here, not because it works, but who do you think, like, in a superhero? I don't care. You don't hurt my feelings. I mean, I'm happy about that. Yeah, that's fine. I mean, I want, you know, like, an honest opinion of what you think, just because of not who I am, because I don't care. Like, I want to see the alternate ending where the White Ranger dies and his head gets cut off. To me, it's kind of cool. But ultimately, power-wise, since you guys know your powers and your superheroes, who would say Spider-Man? You're not going to hurt my feelings. I'm here. Okay, why would you say Spider-Man? Yeah, but the superhero, here's my thing. Big deal. If he puts a web on my mouth, my lips don't move anyway. He's not going to stop. Yeah, if you're a Spider-Man, I talk to you. My lips don't have to move, right? So I was thinking about that. And then I was thinking if he was smart, he would use his spider senses not to even fight me if he knew what was coming. My spider senses tell me the dragon is what's coming. Come on, let's go. I would just say, dude, you would leave
agree. I'm with you.
I said
this,
but you know, it's always that same way. He's like, how about Jason
Brazier? I'm like, that's not. I already know how it's going to end. Two alternate versions.
Two alternate versions.
Who won? The White Ranger or Scorpion?
White Ranger.
How come there's an alternate ending though? Dude, I can't wait till I fight CM Punk. He's like, he scored 100 and he scored 99. Jason and CM Punk both won. Are you going to be like, yeah? And then we're going to both say at the same time, we're the best in the world. It's like, ready, CM? One, two, three. We're the best in the world.
Jason, right. You're my favorite guest of all time. I want to thank the audience, but I really want to thank you and Aaron. Thanks, guys, so much.